Welcome. So nice to see a live audience, first time in 2.5 years. Well, that's a half truth, because we had a 50% capacity at this great concert. So thank you for joining us back in March, just before spring break, when we had our first mini live audience. Today we are live streamed, so if you have family members that weren't able to attend, because it's a kind of a long commute from China or South America, wherever you may have family living, we are still going to continue doing the live streams from here on forthwith, so we can have all our family members tune in and enjoy the show. So sit back. We have a wonderful program of music for you that the students have been working very, very hard. They've particularly come together in the last few months. But I'm not going to talk very much. I'm going to let the program speak for itself. I think what you've seen here tonight is pretty much nothing short of a minor miracle. These kids sound amazing. They're ready to go. They're raring to go. And we're going to start with the concert choir, which is going to stand up right now behind me, please. So some concert etiquette things, just some gentle but firm reminders. First of all, I'm sure you saw in the program photography. If you like to videotape, please don't do it from your seats. It's very distracting when you have a hand in front of the neighbor behind you and they can't see. It blocks their vision. So be present. If you are going to take pictures and video, I ask that you stand at the back or move up to the balcony so that we can be respectful of all our audience members so we don't have a hand in our face. Please and thank you. All right. There was a translation in Korean and Mandarin that was at the front desk where you checked in with the program explaining all of the concert etiquette. One big thing, too, I want to encourage you guys to do is to be loud, responsive, enthusiastic, because we feed off that energy and we've missed it so much during our live stream concerts. And now that we all have a full house here tonight, we really are depending on it. All right? Last comment in terms of just summarizing the concert etiquette. Please stay for the full concert if at all possible and support all of our musicians from start to finish. Here at Glen Eagle, we have a saying, we start strong and we finish strong. From September to the last song of the evening until the last chair is put away, we are a team. We are one mean, lean music machine. All right? So sit back in those comfy chairs. Sorry. I have Advil in my office. If you see me, come see me later. You're back. All right, so sit back and enjoy. I really hope you enjoy the evening, and thank you for celebrating the hard work of your children, your grandkids, your nieces and nephews. I'm extremely proud of them. Let the show begin.
Thank you. solos.
Piano, some lovely piano accompaniment there by Samantha. Thank you.
Well,
my wife's a Newfoundlander, and they have a little song over there, Morphew, and they have all their Newfieisms. This song is an old traditional. It's actually arranged for the guys, and I meant to do it with the guys. The girls got wind of it, and we want to sing it too. So it's an interesting arrangement for SATB. Hope you enjoy it. This is an old Newfie classic. It's called Eyes Dubai.
Good. They're almost ready. If not, I tell a joke. Are we ready? Good. So this is Eyes Dubai, old classic Newfoundland folk song. And it's about fish. All right, little madrigal. Love Is in the Air is our closing number. And I'll say switcheroo for the final number. This is a song that I think will ring a bell for many of you back in the 70s when we all had hair. And it was perhaps a different color. I'm 0 for 2. So, good, they're all back. So we're going to finish off, thank you for doing that so quickly. We're going to finish off with an old classic tune. It's all about love. Love is in the air. Certainly, it's been around the music room for many, many months now, watching the growth and the magic happen in rehearsals, especially in these last several weeks as we've been wrapping things up for the year-end concert. So we'll send you off on this song here from the concert prior to their last tune, Love Is in the Air. Thank you, concert choir. Well done. One more round of applause, please. Can we have some more light on stage, please? Including the psych, anything that helps? Okay. Nothing like a good old march. Thank you so much, you guys. Great opening number. We're going to play the next song for you. It's in 9 movements. So what that means is there are 9 short little pieces. Please hold your applause until the 9th. Did I mention 9? 9 in final movement. Then lots of applause, okay? So this is a fun, real fun piece of music. It's actually pretty challenging. It's very tricky. There's no place for them to hide. They know that, and they're probably going, oh, Mr. T, be quiet. So they worked so hard on this piece. I'm really proud. And we brought in some ringers because there's lots of little percussion parts. So we're going to take you to The Day in the Zoo. This is by Randall Sandbridge. He's one of my favorite composers. It's a fun little piece. If you close your eyes, it's program music, and you can hopefully picture yourself going to the zoo, hearing the marching bands, the monkey pavilion, the sea lions, the carousel, and so on and so forth. There's a bird movement, there's a cheetah pavilion, so there's 9 movements. Actually, I will read them out to you. I forgot, because I didn't put them in the program. I didn't have space. My apologies. So you know what you're listening. The first one, the zoo entrance, marching band. The second movement, the birdhouse. The elephants is the 3rd movement. The cheetahs is the 4th. The carousel, the 5th. Pandas is the 6th. The 7th is the seals, sea lions, and walruses. The 8th movement sounds like my house, the primate pavilion. I have boys at home, did I mention that? So primate pavilion is the 8th, and the last movement is the zoo exit. Again, you'll hear the little marching band as they leave the zoo and exit. Something similar to like what you would hear at Disneyland. All right. Souvenirs in 9 movements. Thank you. Don't go anywhere, percussion. Get back there. Great lungs, get back there. We have some helpers, so I'm going to introduce them to you. In percussion, we have Nathan. Say hi. We have Clinton. Say hi, Clinton. All right. Kai. On bass, Damon, sitting in, one of our peer tutors. Anya, on euphonium. Peter, on the drums, he's going to play Mission Impossible now. Thanks, Peter. And Andrew. So big shout out to our peer tutors. They work pretty hard at catching up a lot of our younger students, especially the ones that started in September. At this time, I would like to recognize all our beginner musicians. These are students that started from scratch in September. They deserve a big round of applause, but before you do that, let me introduce them to you. On flute, Sarah Rajou, standing up. Standing up. Lauren Vance. Ben. Juliana. Nash on tuba, Nash. And let's see, we have a couple newbies. Jenny on percussion. And Alma on percussion. All right. And Brendan's switched to trumpet to help us out. He also has been playing saxophone. So thanks, Brendan, for stepping in and on helping us on trumpet. Good. So big thank you to our beginners. Thank you so much. And our peer tutors. Thank you. Thank you so much, the Junior Concert Band. Thank you. Senior Concert Band, up you get, onto the stage, quickly, quietly. Let's go. Senior Band to the stage, please, right now. Thank you. senior band to the stage, please. Okay, while the senior band is jumping on stage here in short few seconds here, some announcements for you. I'll start with some thank yous. We'll try and intersperse these while we transition on stage to save time, so we have a very smooth, streamlined concert for you tonight. So, because I know the hockey playoffs started tonight, and I'm PVRing the show. All right, I will tell you who I'm rooting for. Not that it really matters. The Canadian teams are all out. Okay, so, special announcements and some reminders from me to you. I want to send out a very sincere and heartfelt thank you to all of the parents and guardians for all of your support throughout the year, especially the last couple of years and change. It's been particularly challenging, and I know it's been a real struggle. I know in our home to support our children at home. I have two teenagers at home myself. I have a 13 and a 17-year-old. So I know what it means to keep these kids energized, motivated, and happy, and moving forward. So a sincere and heartfelt thank you. And I also want to say congratulations because it's working. These kids have been especially resilient this last while, and they're catching on very quickly, and I'm very happy with what I've been seeing over the past several months this year. So a sincere thank you. Thanks also for all the parents that have early morning drop-offs for vocal jazz and jazz band. I know it's not easy getting our students here for those early morning rehearsals. And also to all the parents that pick up after school, especially when it's dark and rainy out. We want to make sure that our children get home safe. Children. Youth. Some of them are bigger than me. All right. A lot of them are. Whatever you're feeding them, it's working. Keep it up. So thanks again. I just really want to say one more time a sincere thank you for your strong and encouragement, your strong and encouraging support for our students. It's been wonderful, and it means a lot. So on their behalf, I know they're teenagers. They don't like to say it, that thanks, Mom and Dad, but I know they mean it, and I know they want to say it. So I'm saying it for them. Thanks. All right. All right, senior band is on. So let's move on with some more music. I'll sneak in a couple more thank yous while they get the last couple students settled in. A special thank you to the parents. Speaking of parents, just a moment ago, huge thank you to Dr. Sue Hackett, Carolyn Berjou, Craig Woods, Lisa Laurie, and Diane Lee for working the door tonight and tickets. So thank you. Big hand to our parents' helpers. Oh, and Carolyn Vett. We have Caroline and Carolyn. So thank you, folks, for helping us at the front door. Also, I think we only have one trustee. It's actually Mr. Craig Woods, who's working the door. So, Mr. Woods, do we have any other trustees here tonight? I didn't see any. Nobody else? Oh, okay. Thank you to all the trustees and for your kind support. Thanks, Mr. Woods. Right, it's going by way too quick. And now seeing Maya now in her last concert. So thanks for all your support to you and all the trustees. I know Carol and the gang, as I call you guys. Carol Calhoun, of course. Means a lot to us when you guys come to all the concerts and the gala and so on. All right. So thanks so much. All right. Now are we ready? Yes. Okay, here we go. We're going to go to Spain now. This is a Spanish march. Thank you. Just a quick introduction while we shuffle the clarinets. If you haven't seen this beautiful movie, it's called How to Train Your Dragon. I've seen them all many times. And I'm sure you have too. I have Pixar playing in my truck all the time. This is a beautiful score. I think a lot of us get so caught up with the movie that often we lose sight of the score. And there's a bunch of new Pixar Disney movies that have some wonderful soundtracks. This one was suggested to me by the students, and I've forgotten how pretty the theme is. It's got a nice Celtic vibe to it, and Sean O'Loughlin has written some beautiful scores lately for Pixar and for Disney. Sit back and enjoy. This is the theme from How to Train Your Dragon.
Thank you.
right, just while they shuffle around. Wasn't that a beautiful piece of music? Yeah, thank you. Well done. Well done, you guys. Well done. Well, we all have our superheroes. I like Spider-Man. I like Superman. I like all of them. But Spider-Man's really cool because he swings. So this is a swinging number. We're going to close off with the theme to Spider-Man. I think we're all settled back here. Well done. Okay. Our last piece for the senior concert band. Then we will have a short, keyword, short intermission. Did I say short? Short intermission, stretch break. We're going to do a quick set change and get on with the second half of the show. Bathrooms are down the hall to the left. Go fast. All right? Or I dock you a letter grade. All right? So bathroom break, quick stretch break. Say hi to some parents because it's been a while. We got to get reacquainted. Stay safe. All that kind of stuff. And we'll be back for the second half rocking, or swinging, I should say, with jazz band. And we'll close out the concert with vocal jazz and some other surprises. All right? So this is Spider-Man, and then we'll take a short, brief break, and then we have stage crew getting things ready for us for the second half. Too sweet. Enjoy Spider-Man. Here we go. This time, can we have some house lights? There's some goodies in the program there for you to enjoy. House lights, please. There's a program there that we put a little bit of time into. Hopefully we didn't miss your son or daughter. There's some announcements in there, and we'll be back shortly. I'm gonna say 7 minutes. Sound good? See you very, very soon. All right, we're going to start the second half now. This is the jazz band. And just as we have everybody taking their seats here for a quick second, we have a 50-50 draw tonight. Woohoo! 50% goes to you, 50% goes to my pension. Thank you. All right. Thanks so much for participating in the 50-50 draw. We will do the draw at the end of the concert. So I need hush upstairs so folks can hear me. All right, so we will do the 50-50 draw at the end of the concert before we sing our final tune in vocal jazz. So you need to be here to win. So don't go anywhere, please. All right, so we will do the draw a little bit later. I have no idea how much the winnings are, but we'll let you know a little bit later in the program, okay? We will probably do one final 50-50 blitz to make sure we don't miss anybody after the jazz band. So we have two fine men, young men, Ian and Matthias, are running around with a red bucket. So after the jazz band, we'll do one final last call for 50-50. Empty your pockets, please, and thank you for your support. We appreciate it very, very much. Okay, now, what we're gonna do is play some more music for you. This is a wonderful tune that Chick Corea wrote, oh my goodness, way back in the early 70s, I think. Chick Corea unfortunately passed away not too long ago, just around Christmas time, January, passed away of cancer, unfortunately. So we'd like to do a little tribute to Chick and all the wonderful music and inspiration he's provided. Right up until his final days, he was working super hard at refining, improving, and stretching his skills on the piano and composition. So God bless him. We're going to miss him, but his music will live on forever with us and our students. So this is a tune called Spain. We're going to feature Jenny on the piano, and then we're going to feature Daniel and Marvin on the saxophones. All right, here's Spain.
Thank you.
been practicing a little Dave Brubeck during rehearsal. We actually had take five almost ready to go, and then Blue Rondo, and we thought we'd do a little Dave Brubeck for you tonight, but we ended up choosing Blue Rondo. It's a much nicer arrangement. So it's a tricky arrangement because Dave Brubeck took the blues, mixed it in the Rondo form, which is a classical term or form in classical music, and the Turk, meaning there's lots of Turkish rhythms, odd meter. So the tune actually switches between 4-4 and 9-8. Okay, so not a song to dance to. I don't recommend it unless you want to end up like a pretzel on the dance floor. All right, so this is a little Dave Brubeck, wonderful composer, arranger for many, many years. And so we are going to feature Tamara on the trumpet, and Melina's going to fill in tonight because Isabel caught a fever. So Melina, no pressure. She just is going to fill in for her tonight. So give her a big hand. Tamara on the trumpet. Did I mention Melina's only in grade 9? And she just found out this morning that she had to fill in tonight. So we wish Isabel well. I hope she's back to school real soon. And the fever is she's already on the mend from what I hear from Dad. So All systems go for Isabel. Well, well done, Melina. That's super courageous. Well done. Tamir, nice job on the solo, too. Well done. Okay, one of my favorite jazz trumpet players that I tend to go to, is my go-to guy, Dizzy Gillespie, the guy with the big puffy cheeks, with the trumpet bent out. In case you ever wondered, the trumpet bending up was an accident. He tripped and dropped his trumpet, and it bent right on the gig as he was going on stage. And he played it all night with the trumpet bent, because he had no choice, and he liked the sound, because he could hear the bell. So then a custom trumpet maker approached him and said, why don't I make you a really nice trumpet with the bell up? And that became his signature. So I think you know the fellow I'm talking about, right? This is Manteca, one great little jazz band chart, Latin fusion funk tune. And we're going to feature, this is our last number for the jazz band. We're going to feature again Daniel on the tenor sax, and we're going to feature Peter on the trumpet. So Manteca by Dizzy Gillespie. Once again, our jazz band, thank you. We just need a quick minute while we switch over to Vocal Jazz, our final ensemble of the evening. Vocal Jazz, come on out. While the rhythm section settles in, I will do some thank yous. I noticed there are lots of staff in the audience tonight. We have some colleagues here. I think I saw Ms. Mulder Tate, Ms. Epp, from staff from not just this school, but other schools. If you're SD 43 staff, could you please stand so we can give you a big thank you? Can we have some house lights? There they are. Thank you. Thanks. The Mallers, of course. Yes. Okay, a real blessing working in this building, especially when we have amazing staff support like we have in this building, and also staff that are in the district. So thank you. Very, very lucky to be working in SD43. So thanks to all those folks. I want to say a shout out to Mrs. Chan and Ms. Shoemaker in the office, and all the ladies in the office for helping out with all kinds of little things like, oh, the float and money and MasterCard and paying for pizzas and so on and so forth. So we have an incredible support team in the front office led by, of course, our wonderful and lovely and graceful leader. Her name is Miss Wendy Yu, our principal. I'm not sure if she's still here because she has little ones. And Miss Zimmer, where's Miss Zimmer? Are you here still? I think she was here earlier. So thanks to our admin team. So give it up for them in our SD43 staff. Okay, there's some more thank yous, but I'll say them for the very end, okay? Because they're very important people, as everybody is in this building right now. This is a song where it's a new song. A lot of people haven't heard of it because it was composed by the very young, the very talented, and I'm sure soon to be a Juno-nominated, if not award-winning, musician. She is the newest sensation that came out of Toronto. Strangely enough, I heard about her from a dear colleague of mine who teaches at Central Washington University, Norm Wallen, who's a well-known arranger for many decades. He got me onto Katie Georgie from Toronto. So this is her composition. It's called Secret Safe. It's just a fun little tune. It's all about love, of course. And I think that's been kind of our, like I mentioned earlier, our theme tonight. So I think we should all be settled and ready to go. Yes, rhythm section, we're all good. This is Secret Safe. We're going to feature Sherry on the piano, and we have some wonderful scatting by this lovely young person over here, Miss Amanda Cabralda.
Come closer, and I'll tell you the secrets that you want to hear. Like how you know just how to make me grin from ear to ear. Or how your smile makes me swoon, my dear. It gets me high as a balloon, my dear. So listen, cause you're missing the most important point of all. So I'll tell you, cause you ought to know your charm is gonna make me fall. There's no denying that I love you, yes, it's true. So come closer and I'll be secret safe with you. Thank you. bop, 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 bop.
That's right. That's how it's done. Amanda's given a clinic in how to scat. Lovely job, Sherry. And let's not forget Mr. Clinton Lee on the drums. Nice. Now I'm going to brag for 2 seconds, am I allowed? Because I'm a very proud teacher, and I'm sure we have very proud parents tonight. Amanda Cabralda, Jewel Epp, and Lizzie, and I think that's it. Have been accepted to the very prestigious Capilano University vocal program. Uh-huh. Lizzie, take a bow. Jewel. And Amanda, one more time. And I know a lot of the other singers I know are going to be pursuing singing. Gian has over 250,000 followers on YouTube and social media. So follow Gian Ross. She's going to be rich and famous. I'm her new manager. 10%. Or I drop you a letter grade. All right. I know a lot of our grade 12s are going to be destined for greatness. So whether they pursue music as a profession or as a serious hobby, hopefully they'll stick with it. And I gave a little program note at the beginning about the importance of sticking with music. We're all into adulthood. There's tons of research that proves that music, it does wonders. And the proof was in the pudding when COVID hit its worst. I called the music store going, oh gosh, I'm so sorry, my program's been decimated by 50%. Huh? They were selling keyboards, computers, microphones. People were going back to their music after many, many years or decades, having missed their music programs as children, and buying and recording and learning guitar at home on YouTube, picking up the piano, learning their instruments that had been long lost or buried in the closet or the basement or what have you. So some good things came out of COVID. And one of the best things that came out of COVID was music. Don't forget it, folks. It's wonderful, powerful, incredible tool to do good in the world and to soothe this and this. Got it? Nice. Good. Well, we're going to dedicate this next song to some pretty special people. This song is dedicated to you, all our parents, for all your love and support, for these incredible young teenagers you see in front of you. This is When I Think About Angels. We're going to feature the lovely, the talented Jewel Epp.
Passes by.
Swear.
I swear I hear you in
side. Beautiful distraction. You make every thought a chain reaction. When I think about rain, I think about singing. When I think about singing, it's a heavenly tune. When I think about heaven, then I think about angels. When I think about angels, I think about you. Anywhere I go, anything I do, everything around me, baby, makes me think of you. When I think about rain, I think about singing. When I think about singing, it's a heavenly tune. When I think about heaven, then I think about angels. When I think about angels, I think about you. When I think about rain, I think about singing. When I think about singing, it's a heavenly tune. When I think about heaven, then I think about angels. When I think about angels, I think about you. When I think about rain,
yeah, Julep. Okay. All right, we're coming up to the final tune, but before we do that, we're going to have, I should say a couple of quick comments here about this incredible group of singers you see in front of them, in front of you. They were invited to perform at the Teacher School District 43 Teacher Retirement Function last week on Thursday night, which really is indeed an honor, and we often get the first call. Not that I asked for it, and it's a tough one to say no. And it's a lot of work, and it's a very long day, and they didn't just perform. They got a standing ovation. All right? So, well worth it. That night would not have been possible if it wasn't for Kai's mom. Where's Leah Holland?
She's here.
Oh, she's not here. Right, I forgot. She's watching on live stream. Well, anyway, so Kai and her mom, and Mr. Maller. Where's Mr. Maller? He's hiding. There he is. Mr. Maller, thank you very much for all your help. Mr. Maller didn't do one trip. He did three trips to the hotel back and forth between kids and equipment, and we didn't get back home until, I don't know, 10:30 at night, eh, Justin? It was a long one. Thanks, my brother. Thanks for being such a great colleague and companion to work with at school. Where'd he go? You keep moving on me. There he is. Big shout out to Mr. Maller. Thank you. And to Kai's mom. And where's Connor? So Connor, Kai, and who's that other helpers? Lizzie. Thanks for staying right to the very end once again. And all to all the Vocal Jazz kids for doing such a great job. Also want to thank, a big heartfelt thank. Can we have some house lights? Behind the board tonight, we have Finnegan. We have Chris Marsh, who's a grad. We have Connor and the wonderful team. Their names are in the program. So a big shout out to all the tech team for all your lighting and all the work you've done all year with all the LCD projector things. Fantastic job. Good job. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, now some housekeeping things. Next year, we're hoping to have a full return of the Jazz Gala. I have some irons in the fire already. Something to do with some Juno-nominated and award-winning musicians will be here on this stage to likely perform for us in February. Those tickets are going to sell out, I guarantee it, okay? So stay tuned. We're going to be looking for a strong team of new parents to get involved with the what we call our Glen Eagle parent community, our parent group. It's a lot of fun. It's not a ton of work. And if there's no fun, we're not doing the raising. Get it? Fundraising. Okay. My wife tells me to leave the jokes alone. Okay, I should listen. All right, so the Jazz Gala and hopefully a small tour next year. We've been invited to a couple of festivals. The one I really like right now that's sticking on my mind is Whistler. It's called Cumbrio, and it's local and it's safe. They ran it this year at 50% capacity, and it did very well. And so there's good news coming. So long story short, with any luck, we'll see what happens over the summer. Fingers and toes crossed that hopefully come September and into the fall, we'll be able to return to a full regular program for the rest of the year moving forward. So there we go. That's the big announcement. So stay tuned. I'll have more information for you in the fall. And there may likely be a parent meeting in the fall, especially if we're looking at going on tour. We'll have to do deposits pretty quick. They wanted them now, but I'm not comfortable sending in deposits yet. I want to wait until after the summer. So if you do move with the Whistler trip, it's going to be a quick decision. I'll have to make it before the end of September, early October. Otherwise, the festival will likely sell out. It's that good. We did it before in 2017. It was fantastic. Okay, so that's the good news for today. That, I think, deserves some applause. Yay, some good news. Yay. All right. Thank you for the house lights. Thank you. Thank you, team up there. And now, for the next and final song, and then after the final song, I have a short little presentation, but so don't go anywhere, okay? It won't take long, I promise. All right. Oh, I was trying to take the money all, darn. Okay, 50-50 tickets. Can I have the bucket? You caught me red-handed. Oh. All right, where's my bucket? Where's the bucket? And what is the total, gentlemen?
182.
1,882?
Oh,
$182. The winner goes to $182. Can we have more lights, please? Drum roll, Clinton. $599-3076. 599-3076. Going once. Going twice. Do you have a winner? 599-3076. And that's all we have. Come on, come on down. Don't be shy. Thank you. Yes. There you go. Yeah, you're welcome. Hey, thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Can you just put the lid on, just put it aside? Okay, now our final song. We have some horns in the back. So this is a tune that goes back to 1977. So a little bit of a throwback. I hope you like this tune. It was a big tune, a famous song by Styx. It's called Come Sail Away. And we'd like to dedicate this song to all our grade 12s. May they sail away in great fortune and to very bright futures, as I know they all have. So here we go. This is for you, grads of 2022. Come sail away. Sorry, one more thing. Kai on the solo and Luke on the solo.
An open course to the virgin sea, 'cause I've got to be free, free to face the life that's ahead of me.
On board I'm the captain, so climb aboard. We'll search for tomorrow on every shore, but we'll try best that we can to carry on. Yeah.
this song of hope, and this is what they said. They said, come sail away, come sail away, come and sail away with me. Come sail away, come sail away, come and sail away with me. Come sail away, come sail away, come and sail away with me. Come sail away, come sail away, come and sail away with me.
Well done, you guys. Thank you so much. For you, grade 12. Speaking of the grade 12s, I would like all the grade 12s, there's 28 of them, right down here in about 10 seconds flat. Go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Oh, there goes my pencil. 'Cause not every day I hand out a flower to a kid, but you know what? This is the first time everything. No. Listen, you know what? This is a Glen Eagle tradition. It's been 2.5 years. We're doing it tonight. This is a carnation for the students. Take one. One. You had enough pizza. Let's go. Let's go. Take one. Pass along. Take one. Take one. Take one. Let's go. Here. Peter, be a good sport, take the bucket. Who's got free hands? Liz. Okay, pass it along. You guys handle flowers. I will talk. All right. Take one, pass it along. Carnations. Oh, thanks, Mr. Maller. Carnations date back over 2,000 years to when I was a young boy. 2,000 years, young boy, all right. I should have listened to my wife. They are rich with symbolism. Quiet, please. Thank you. Carnations, shh. I'm giving an important speech. The last one you'll hear from me forever. No respect, eh? Same thing at home, right? Yeah? Teenagers. Carnations date back over 2,000 years. They are rich with symbolism. Thanks, Mr. Mallory. With symbolism, mythology, and even debate. Yes, debate. A flower, really? The Greek scholars suggest that the name came from the word koron, or coronation, as this flower was used to decorate ceremonial crowns back in the day. Today, they come in a wide array of colors, with each color having symbolic meaning. For example, love, luck, admiration, and get the heck out of high school. Anyway, carnations are often worn on Mother's Day, Teacher's Day. I haven't gotten one yet. 30 years, no carnations. Note to parents. All right, St. Patrick's Day, they come in green, which when they finally came out in green, that was fun. They're also very popular due to their sweet fragrance and longevity. Hence, to our grade 12s, I wish you a long and fruitful, bright future. Many, many happy returns. We're incredibly proud of you. I know I'm speaking on behalf of myself, our musical family here at Gleneagle, all the staff that have had the joy to work with you for the past 4 years, well, most of you, but anyway, and of course, some of the parents, all right? Congratulations, grade 12s. Round of applause. Thank you. All right. And there's three people that if it weren't for them, we wouldn't be able to put on concerts. So Sherry, Samantha, and Nathan, please come out. Our three amazing accompanists. Mr. Nathan. Samantha and Sherry, they took off to Dairy Queen. No, there they are. Let's go, ladies. Don't run. Don't. Please walk. Don't run. Like when I was a lifeguard. Please walk. Don't run. Don't slip and kill and hurt yourselves. This is Sherry and Samantha, our wonderful accompanists. They put in many, many hours. And thank you, Nathan. All right. One last time, take a bow, folks. Congratulations. Happy grads. Where'd Mr. Mallor go? For you, sir. Thanks. Thanks, brother. Okay. All right. Folks, I'm tired. It's been a heck of a year. It's been a wonderful year. Immense growth from all our students. They deserve a great audience. You were it. Thanks for being here. Thanks for the support once again. Have a safe and happy summer. I hope to see all of you back very soon. And you're listening because report cards are due next week. Uh-huh. All right. I see Mr. Bird in the audience. All right. Okay, all right. Folks, we hope to listen. It's about 8 minutes to nine. Cleanup will be done in 9 minutes, or I drop them all at later grade. Deal, parents? Nice. Folks, happy summer. Thanks again for being here. Enjoy yourselves. Say hello. We'll see you all in the fall. Thank you. Good night.